Hallelujah. Come on. Celebrate Jesus. Celebrate Jesus. Celebrate Jesus. Thank you.
Thank you. Hallelujah. Can somebody put your hands together for the Lord? Hallelujah. We are here to give him the glory and honor that he deserves. Hallelujah. Come on, put your hands together this way. Come on. Glory and honor.
Glory and honor, dominion and power,
you.
Hallelujah. You don't deserve a praise. You are worthy. You are holy. Thank you, Jesus.
Come on, celebrate the choir. Celebrate the choir. Our God is worthy of all our praise. Worthy of all our honor, worthy of all our adoration. If he is worthy, lift up your hands and shout a very big hallelujah. Can you lift up your hands and shout glory? Shout it again, glory. That is what your life will look like. When people see you, they will see the glory of the Lord. Something new is happening today. I don't know what that thing is. Something new is there's something about today. From the first day, this meeting keeps moving from one level to another. The level of joy we have seen today, we didn't see it other days. And wherever you see people celebrating, it means something good has taken place. Somebody shout hallelujah. And you know, it as it is in heaven, so it is here on earth. Heaven is celebrating about somebody's victory today. Heaven is rejoicing about somebody's breakthrough today. Every time in those days, I used to be a football addict. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody follow me and say, thank you, Jesus. Let me give you a little history. 1980, when all African games took place, I was at Lagos in the university. I left my house in the morning, left the campus in the morning, stayed from that morning, 9 a.m. Football, they will play by 4 p.m. I stayed there till 4 p.m. They finished the football. Where is boss for you to go back? You trade from national, and you're happy to do it. The one thing I notice is that every time you hear a shout somewhere, it is the winning side that is shouting. Today you are on the winning side. Somebody shout! Hallelujah. Every day God gives us a word concerning that day. And today God led me to Acts of the Apostles chapter 5 verse 12. And by the hands of the apostles were many signs and wonders wrought among the people. Brethren, I can say 100% with 100% assurance, I know without any iota of doubt that God's servant that is sent to us today carries the mantle of an apostle. I know he's our Archbishop, but I know he carries the mantle of what? An apostle. And everywhere apostles go, new things, new trials are blessed. Someone here must have been the reason why God allowed us to bring him. This scripture will be fulfilled in your life today. By the hands of apostles, many, not one, many signs and wonders. No wonder we were shouting and dancing and celebrating. Something wonderful is happening in your life today. I am glad this evening to welcome God's servant. He does not need introduction. Archbishop Cletus, Bassey, the apostle of God to minister to us. Come on, celebrate God's servant. Celebrate God, celebrate God.
Lift up those hands and give him praise to him. Wave to the Lord to your right and to your left. Wave those hands and let him see your hands. Let him see a generation praising him. The songwriter said a generation let's praise him. Amen. Thank you, Pastor. Thank you with your beloved wife and your family. For inviting us and making us a part of this great move of the Holy Spirit. Thank you. And all the pastors and all the leaders and elders and workers and beautiful choirs. Wonderful. Hallelujah. I love the children when I hear them shout. Come on, children. Hallelujah. Today is a beautiful day, and I am so happy to be here. I don't take it lightly that I'm being invited to be a part of this great service, and we have come to just share a little bit of who we know God. The season of God's glory is the season of rest. In the season that your activities come to an end while God is at work. And so tonight, as we come, I would love for you to loosen up, be free, and let Daddy God speak to you. Let him love on you a little bit. So don't try to be all, you know, just relax. Tell your neighbor, relax. Come on, people. Tell your neighbor on your right hand, relax. And the one behind you, if you have any, relax. Stop being too organized.
I bow before your throne. I bow before.
Father, tonight we bow before you. Tonight we cast our crowns, our worries. We cast all that has disturbed our lives, our hearts, our minds.
Knowing that you are in the midst of your people.
Cause your word to come alive. Let your children be blessed. Let there be a turnaround in their lives. Let, oh God, your purpose be established. Bless your children. Satan, I take authority over you in the name of Jesus. I command you to take off your hands from everyone that is here now. Every sickness in the body, I command them to disappear. Every disease in the body, I command them to disappear. I demand by the Spirit of the living God that Father God, you will be glorified, you will be honored. You will rise by your Spirit and show yourself mighty. Thank you, Father. Amen. If you believe it, shout amen. Hallelujah. Please, you may be seated. God bless you. Now, I want you to not be in a hurry tonight in the next few minutes that God would allow us to be here. He will reach you tonight. If you came here for God to reach you, say amen. I'm trying to get myself here.
Let your hand and let your glory.
Let your glory.
Let your glory
fill this house.
Let your glory.
Let your glory.
Let your glory.
Let your
glory.
Let your glory.
I know you have prayed, I know you have fasted, I know you have done what you knew best to do, but the Lord said, leave me and let me have my way. Let your reasoning step out of the way and let me be God. Because it is your season. It is your season to rise above where you have found yourself. It is your season to experience my power and my glory. It is your season to begin to come into that which I have said concerning you. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Let your glory be. Let your glory
be. Let the sick be healed.
Let
those
your glory
who
be.
Are overcome by the powers of darkness be set free, O God.
Let your glory be.
Thank you.
Now, let me say this to you. I am not coming here to do much of preaching. I will say a little bit of what, you know, what I think I should say. But I came here to speak into somebody's life tonight. I saw these beautifully decorated canopies in 10 places.
Hallelujah.
And I was wondering what was going on, and they said to me that weddings will be taking place in this house this year.
Hallelujah.
Plenty weddings.
Hallelujah.
Also that this year there is what we call the Millionaire's Club. While they say there is a recession, God said that there is a restoration. Therefore, I see cars being dedicated. I see houses being dedicated.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Cars and houses. I also see those people who struggled to travel before. I see you with visas.
Amen, 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 amen.
Now, please hear me and hear me well. Under this unction of the Holy Spirit, whatever that is spoken by his prophet shall be established.
Amen.
Don't be afraid of what God is about to do with you, because I have seen that there are a few of you that have had a shaking, and the shakings, the Lord said, those shakings are over. In your marriage, in your office, and in your business, three levels of shakings that took place just as we are just here, heavens are open over you, and that marriage is sanctioned by God. That business is protected by heaven. That office is given to you with promotion. This is your year of not struggling. Is your year of walking into your miracle. Where you see the glory, you see the manifestation of God's glory and power. Therefore, as it is declared, from glory to glory, it means from January to December, something marvelous will happen. Yes.
What a marvelous God. What a marvelous God. He has done marvelous things for me.
What a marvelous God. What a wonderful God. He's yet to do marvelous things again. What a marvelous God. What a marvelous God. He has done marvelous things for me. What a wonderful God. What a marvelous God. He was doing it again and again.
What a marvelous God. What a marvelous God. He has done marvelous things for me.
Are you there?
What a marvelous God. What a marvelous God. He's yet to do marvelous things for me.
A marvelous God.
What a marvelous God. What a marvelous God. He has done marvelous things for me. What a marvelous God. What a marvelous God. He's yet to do marvelous things for me.
The things that are impossible, that no man can do, are the things He will do it again and again. A marvelous God.
What a marvelous God. What a marvelous God. He has a marvelous thing to be.
A marvelous thing.
What a marvelous God. What a marvelous. He's yet to do marvelous things.
What a marvelous God.
What a marvelous God. What a marvelous God. He has a marvelous thing for me. What a marvelous
God, what a marvelous thing for me. Hallelujah. 21 days from today, your story will change in such a dramatic way that people will not recognize it's the same person again.
Amen.
21 days from today. 21 days from today. You are going to be the first partaker of this world.
Amen, 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 amen.
I see a 19-year-old girl. Your situation began when you were 12. But as I'm standing here, I'm seeing you that you have gone from one house to another house to another house to another house. You are 19 now. But the Lord said that something is going to happen on your 21st year. A miracle that will baffle the whole of your family. And what will happen is that somebody will recommend you, and at the age of 21, please note this, somebody who is 23 years old will propose to you. He is not in Nigeria, but you will be in America on your 21st year.
Amen.
Now, I have what to preach, so don't think I didn't come here to preach. Right? You know, I have obeyed the voice of whom I have known for many years now. You have left things happen within your top. And it has been everything right from to a time. And then sometimes I think you have numbness. But as I'm speaking to you now, the Lord has just healed you. You have come into a season that you will see the glory of God back to back. Every month will reveal the glory of the Lord in your life in the name of Jesus. I came to announce to somebody here that you are among those that have been shortlisted. I see about three of you here that will have an appointment that is coming. I see three of you. You are going to be among them that will be appointed. I don't know whether in a board or certain things, but there will be an appointment that is coming. Battles have been raging, but it has been taken care of right now. Oh,
your life. Come on.
Amen.
Oh yes. Oh yes.
Amen.
Oh yes. Oh yes.
Here to hear what I wanted to say, because I have received some strange calls says to us, in Revelation 17, tell us that this nation is out of their hands. In the next few months, we shall begin to be reviewed over what is going to happen. Because you see, when men think that they are in control of things, and they are doing it without respecting Jehovah, who owns the nation, then God will sneak at them. And when that happens, the Bible says that mountains shall begin to skip like rams. And then things will begin to fall in line. It will first of all get worse, then it shall begin to align. Now let me say to you that this nation of Nigeria is God's own nation. No man can lay claim over this nation. And no man can say what God has not said. And so as a result of that, as the Church of Jesus Christ, we are saying the hour has come that the glory of the Lord shall be revealed in the nation of Nigeria. If you are among those that believe, shout three, amen. Now we are not speaking as individuals, we are speaking collectively. There is not individual pastor or individual church. The Church of Jesus Christ is speaking one word right now. We have been sleeping for too long. I think that God is using the enemy to wake us up. And as we are being woken up, the Bible says you are the light of the world. You are the salt of the earth. You are the city that is set on a hill. Let me say something to you. It is not government that should decide what is going to happen. It is the church. And when the church begins to decide what is going to happen, something will kill you. And I want you to know that the hour has come that the church will have to rise and bring direction to our nation and our generation. If you believe, shout amen. Therefore, be careful. Because what you are calling from glory to glory, you might have said it as a word or words. And you would say that it is glory to glory. But I want you to hear me and hear me well. It is not normal. It is completely not normal. It is completely out of normal that you are living in this generation at this time. God had had to keep this time for you and I to be alive to see what is going to happen so that you can honor God. What will happen in the world is going to cause men to fear God. It will cause men to fear God. That even those who call themselves atheists, they'll begin to name the name of the Lord. Something is going to happen in the world. I want you to watch out. Because the world is going to shake from one end to the other. And God, the God of heaven, will begin to let his glory fill the earth. So that men will know that he is the only one that owns the heavens and the earth. So your family and all that you have, I want you to bring them under the covering of God. Every day you wake up, begin to pray a covering prayer. A prayer of covering over all that you have, wherever they go. So that none of them will enter into any form of either turbulent, enter into any situation, enter any aircraft that is going to crash, enter any car that is going to have accidents, enter any case that is going to become marked for danger and for death, but that every one of their people, any vehicle they enter is safe and secure. Every airline they enter is safe and secure. Whatever thing they do, they are in the right place at the right time. Because something is going to happen, the nations will shake. Things will begin to crumble. Men will hold at their hands. Because in this season, God is going to raise the nobodies to become the commanders of industries. Servants will begin to command so much wealth that their masters will not know what to do. Therefore, I want to say to you, don't let your heart be troubled. You have believed in God, believe also in God or Jesus Christ, that it shall be well with you. In the name of Jesus. Please be seated. Let me just say a few words with you, then I will leave. Are you ready? I'm going to read from the scripture that you have read already. Isaiah chapter 6. It is not a new scripture. It is the scripture you've read already. Arise. Shine. For your light has come. And the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. Arise. Tell your neighbor, arise. Please hear. hear me and hear me well. God is commanding us to rise up. Arise. You cannot shine till you rise. Many people want to shine, but they are not rising. Arise and shine, for your light has come. Tell your neighbor, your light has come. The days of His glory are the days of your light coming. When the glory of God comes, it means that your light has come. Your light has come. Your light in your family has come. Your light in your business has come. Your light in your village has come. Your light in your neighborhood has come. Your light in every place that you find yourself, your light has come. On campuses, your light has come. That is the word of the Lord as we begin to zero into the end time. And the glory of the Lord is risen. Somebody said the rising of the glory. Come on, say it one more time. Now, the rising of the glory is in your obedience. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord is upon you. The glory of the Lord is upon you because you have risen up. The church has been sitting down for too long. The only thing we've been doing is just call for prayer, but we are not standing up for the truth. We are not standing up for the things that the Lord has told us. Therefore, if we must see the light shining and the glory coming upon us, we must rise up. Rise up and be counted. Stand out and let people know who you are. Many people don't know that there are some people who are Christians because they cover up a lot. When it is time to speak up, they are not saying anything. That is why when they go to the Senate, you don't hear them say things when they ought to be talking. When they are in the House of Representatives, they are not saying anything, but they are Christians. Matters that affect the church, you don't hear church people say anything or rise up to resist. But God said, arise. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. Look at verse 2. For behold, the darkness shall cover the earth, and deep darkness the people. But the Lord will arise over you, and His glory will be seen upon you. Now, when do we need the glory? Is when darkness is over everywhere. Darkness is everywhere. Where darkness is, that is where the glory of God wants to be. So it is not to run away when there is darkness. No, what you need to do is to stand, because the glory of God is coming. God is looking for people that will make Him let His glory come. Looking for those youths. I saw you dancing, rejoicing. It is not normal. It's not usual. It's because something has happened in your spirit. That very heaviness has been broken. You can now see the heavens over you have been opened. And you can see that joy is coming out from the inside of you. The church of Jesus Christ can never be silent. And I hear you say, amen. Therefore, we are living in the most exciting moment since the church started. Because the end time church is the church of His glory. The end time church is the church of His power. The end time church is the church of witnessing God in an action that people will never believe it is possible. Therefore, you are going to be among those that will see the glory of God. If you are among those that will say, amen. But you see, This glory is a supernatural thing. It's an encounter with God. You have to come to that place where you encounter God supernaturally, because that is where the glory of the Lord is. Arise, shine, because the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. It is not it may, it is not it will, it is not it could, it has risen. The glory is upon you. I said the glory is upon you. If you believe it, shout a big hallelujah. That is why when you look at the book of Haggai, chapter number 2, please look at the book of Haggai. I told you, I'm not going to read something new. I'm just going to bring some of the things you have heard, and then I will share with you what the Lord told me. And while I was praying for you, I've been on my knees praying and asking the Lord as I was watching this service. The Lord said to me, I told you already about my glory. Go back and tell them what I said to you. Because you see, my people are limited for lack of knowledge of what I am doing. They do not understand the levels and the dimensions upon which things happen. And let them know what I said to you. And then I began to see promotion come to the church. I began to see lifting come to the church. I began to see such liberty that will come to the church. And I noticed that people began to align themselves upon what God is to do. They began to align themselves to now respond to the voice of the Lord. If there's anything we needed, it's the voice of God. And when you know this is God saith the Lord, follow it. For your victory is in the voice of the Lord. If you are among those that will obey God, say amen. Amen. Chapter 2 of the book of Haggai. The Lord God said, verse 6, but thus saith the Lord of hosts, once more it is written a while, it is a while, bleak, a little while, I will do what? I will shake heaven, and I will do what? I shake the earth, the sea, and dry land. For I will shake how many nations? Please, how many nations? There is no nation that the Lord God will not shake in this season we have come into. Every nation shall be shaken. Every nation shall be shaken. Every nation shall be shaken. You need to understand this so that you will not be taken unaware. You will not say, we did not know. Because the Spirit of the Lord is beginning to speak to the church and letting the church know what he is about to do. The nation shall shake. I didn't hear you. And I will shake all nations. Why would the Lord shake the nations? Look at the next statement. I will shake all the nations. Because of what? And the desires of all nations. And they shall come to the desire of all nations. And I will fill this temple with what? Ha ha! Says the Lord of hosts. I will fill this temple with this glory. The nations, the desires of the nations, because they are going to be in such a trouble or problem that their economic experts will fail them. The only thing that will wait and will help them will be the wisdom of God. So therefore, the nations shall shake. Religious organizations are shaking. The economy of nations are shaking. The political structures are shaking. The ethnic systems are shaking. Many are now running from one place to the other. Nobody knows where to go to anymore. Why? It is the prophetic word that God gave. Verse 9, the glory of this latter temple. The glory of this latter house. The glory of this latter house. The temple that you are now coming into, said the glory of this latter temple shall be greater. Somebody say greater. He says shall be greater than the former, says the Lord of hosts. And in this place I will do what? Give peace, says the Lord of hosts. So when there are troubles and the nations are shaking, in God you shall have peace.
God is him. That's what he has said. I believe that we are in the season that the glory is coming back to the church. In the face of all that is going on, don't be afraid. The glory of God is coming back to the church. No matter how painful certain things are to you, don't forget this. The glory of the Lord is coming back to the church. So we see that in the midst of all of this, God's glory is rising. Because there are people who are desirous. They are desiring the presence of God. So when we say the glory of God, what is the glory of God? The glory of God is the presence of God. The glory of God is the presence of God. The glory of God is the presence of God. Say that to your neighbor. The glory of God is the presence of God. Say that with me. That is all. How do I know the glory of God is the presence of God that makes up the glory of God? It is the presence of God that is the glory of God. Sometimes it may not be in the shakings, like the wind shaking the house. The presence of God many times can come into a place, there is no noise, but there is direction. There is faith. The glory of God is the manifest presence of God. Therefore, when we are saying from glory to glory, we mean to say that we will not lack the presence of God. In 2017, we will not lack the presence of God. In your small meetings, as youth, the presence of God will invade you. When you are coming in to do rehearsal as choir people, the presence of God will envelop you. When the women are meeting to plan their meeting, the glory of God will come upon them. So we are coming into the season of the presence. Somebody say, God's presence. That is what the glory is about. The presence of God. It means that God is saying to us, in this season, you are going to encounter me. You are inside the bus. The presence of God comes into the bus. And when that happens, anything can happen. When you feel the presence of God on campus, it means somebody is about to see, because the presence of God is to be revealed. You don't have the presence of God for it to be kept like in a cupboard. The presence of God is coming because there shall be manifestations. Therefore, you shall see signs and wonders. Oh, let your amen reach God today. Let me give you a few things here. When we talk about the presence of God, we talk about the presence of God, the glory of God. What do we mean? We say that it is the tangible presence. It is an encounter, not knowledge. Many people have the knowledge of God, but they have not encountered God. They have read about God in the Bible. They know that there is one man called Jesus, born by a Virgin Mary in Bethlehem of Judea. But have you encountered him? In this season of his glory, you are not only going to have the knowledge of God, but you are going to see the manifest presence. So it is not only the knowledge, but it is an encounter. Lift up your right hand, say, God. Say, Father, may I encounter you this year. Is that your prayer? So it is not knowledge. It is not just knowledge. We have too many knowledgeable Christians. If you ask them about the doctrines of the church, they can tell you. They tell you about the doctrines of Christ, laying on of hands, baptism, you know, resurrection. You know, they can give you all that has to do with the knowledge of the Word of God. But we must go beyond the knowledge. No sick person should come into our midst and go back with sickness. No sinner should come into our midst and go back a sinner. No backslider should enter, encounter us, and go back a backslider. No, something must have to happen. And I said to you, in this day of His glory, there shall be encounters. I said there shall be encounters. No man will come in with demonic power and is comfortable in our churches. No, the power of God shall begin to shake everywhere. And that demonic power will just scream and leave the body. Somebody shout glory! So it is not just the knowledge. It is an encounter. Number two, it is an atmosphere of heaven on earth. That is what the glory is about. An atmosphere of heaven on earth. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. So, when we talk about the glory of the Lord, we are referring to God's atmosphere. It is an atmosphere. Labosadahade. It is an atmosphere. Now, don't tell me this is church and there is no God. Don't tell me this is church and Jesus is not in the house. Don't tell me that we are believers and demons are still coming in and they are comfortable. My Bible speaking said to me about Samuel and Saul. The Bible says that Saul was so angry that David ran to Samuel. And so he sent for them. He said his soldiers, go and pick David. Bring him here dead or alive. Oh, Jesus. The soldiers came. And as they came into the atmosphere of the prophetic, where the sons of the prophets were gathering, in an atmosphere, nobody spoke to them. Samuel and all the prophets and the Levites were singing, Kodida madare kusudianana kuyara kutere. And yes, while they are coming, the atmosphere has been charged. The devil came to take one of them. The devil came to pick David. The devil said, pick David for me. How do we stay in the church and Satan is picking the children of God and killing them one after the other? Where is the atmosphere of heaven? Hey! So the soldiers made the mistake to enter the atmosphere. Nobody spoke to them.
Nobody told them anything. But somehow, they began to dance in the spirit. They were doing exactly what Samuel and David and the sons of the prophets were doing. They began to dance. They began to dance. Kanobosha, kanobosha, kanobosha. With their knives, with their sword, as soldiers, they forgot what they were sent because an atmosphere had been changed. An atmosphere had been changed. Saul was told, look, your soldiers you sent, they are all prophesying. He said, what nonsense is that? How will they disobey? How will they disobey my orders? He sent another detachment. Go there. Bundle both the soldiers and David. Bring them back here. The atmosphere was on. Oh, sing, oh, praise the Lord. Oh, sing, oh, praise the Lord. Oh, sing, oh, praise the Lord. 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 The enemy heard them singing. They thought it is the normal way of Christians singing. That is how they said, now let's go. Arrest David. In fact, if that Samuel will disobey, pick him also. The atmosphere. A certain circumference has been set that if you dare cross the line, the magnetic field will pull you. They didn't understand what happened to them. The second set began to prophesy. It shall be well. It shall be well with David, the servant of the Most High. It shall be well with David, the servant of the Most High. It shall be well with David, the servant of the Most High. Hey! That is not what you were sent, but we cannot help but prophesy. I see that atmosphere charged. In your house, in your office, by your marketplace, anywhere you are, I see that atmosphere charged. The second set is done prophesying. It is well with David, the servant of the Lord. It is well with David, the servant of the Lord. Messenger went back. Sir, live forever. King Saul. The second set, they are now prophesying. What nonsense. I will now go by myself. I'm talking about the commander in chief with all his artillery, with all his best equipment, with all that he has and owns. He began to come to show forth who he is, what he has as the president of the United States of Israel. Samuel did not keep quiet. The priest of God did not keep quiet. The singers were still singing. I love God. I love God. When the atmosphere is ready, you don't pray for miracles. Miracles just happen. Who is that devil that can stand in the presence of the Lord? What sickness can stand in the presence of the Lord? Whether you are blind, you are lame, you are whatever, you are dumb. When the presence of God envelops a place, miracles must happen. Hey! Saul, the king, is finding himself hearing, oh sing, oh sing, praise the Lord. Oh sing, oh sing. He said, is that all? Is that all that these stupid trained soldiers could go and do this kind of nonsense? Let's go. Oh sing, oh sing, praise the Lord. I remember the 70s when we were singing and clapping. There were no drums. We were clapping with our hands. Our hands were the instruments. When we were singing and we were dancing and we were shouting, we saw more power than all the instruments today. What has happened to the church? The glory has departed. But thank God the glory is coming back. I said the glory is coming back. I said the glory is coming back. That is how Saul entered the atmosphere. When he entered the atmosphere, something hit him. Come. He said, what is that? Stop that nonsense. Stop that nonsense. I am the king. I am. No, I cannot. I cannot. It will not touch me. Come. I know it cannot touch me. It cannot. The others are looking at him, wondering what has happened to Saul. What has happened to Saul? Saul began to go one leg, and then stop the other one, and then, before you know it, Saul is on the ground. His clothes are open and torn. He is busy prophesying more than any other person. Somebody shout glory! Come on, shout glory! That is how Saul prophesied from morning till night. So the glory of God is an atmosphere of heaven on earth. You shall experience it. If your amen is louder, take it now. Given up the time. Let me share this to you. That the glory of God is a realm of rest. A realm of rest. You have labored for so long, toiled back and forth. Nothing has really, really helped you. You are working so much, yet you don't have. When the glory descends, an atmosphere of rest is created for you, and you shall rest. 2 Corinthians chapter 3 verse 18. Look at some scripture there. 2 Corinthians chapter 3 verse 18. Let me just show you something as we move on. But we all, somebody say, how many of us? How many of us? Children are not included. Women are not included. The youth are not included. The men are not included. Only pastors are included. What did he say? Shout it. We all with unveiled face, beholding as in a mirror the glory of the Lord, are being transformed unto the same image from glory to glory, just as the Spirit of that is the scripture for which this place has gotten victory here. He said all of us, not some of us, all of us. It does not matter how your face looks like. He said we all, with that kind of faith that have been unveiled by the blood of Jesus, we are now being transformed. Somebody say transformed. Therefore, glory comes in the place of transformation. You are being transformed, changed. Not the mantra of APC. This change is not something that is political. No, it's deeper than politics. It is scriptural, called transformation. Transformation. Therefore, the glory is in a person. That is why it is in his presence. The glory is in a person. God himself. Which means it does not consider you or I.
No, it is everything about him. Him all in himself, by himself, in his class. So when you are talking about the glory of God, remove yourself. Remove your pastor. Remove every other person that will determine how it will work. It is all about God. The glory is all about God. Can I hear you say it's all about God? In closing, let me show you these three dimensions in which, if you are to operate in the supernatural, how these three dimensions play a major role. Number one is the dimension of faith. Somebody says faith. Come on, can I hear you say faith? Can I hear you say faith? How many of you know that faith is everything? As touching your relationship with God, it is about faith. Without faith, it is impossible to do what? He that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently do. The just shall live by Jesus. Before he will heal the sick, he said to you, do you believe that you have faith? Do you believe I can do this? What did the people say? I believe. What will he answer them? Let it happen to you according to. So faith is very important. So it means if I am to come into an atmosphere of the supernatural, I need faith. I need faith to work for me. I need to operate by faith. I need to begin to speak things by faith. Saying those things that be not as though they were. Speaking those things, sometimes they look very heavy, but God said it to me. But God told me. But God mentioned it. So faith, somebody said faith. The dimension of faith, that is how you have become a Christian. Faith cometh by, and so therefore faith is a function of what? The instrumentality of the word of God. Ability to hear, revelation, rhema, that is how faith comes. But how many of you can tell me the truth? Please, tell me the truth and line up, okay? I'm about closing. Tell me the truth and line up, as I'm sitting down. But I want to look at your faces. Holy faces. People who are holy don't laugh. I'm looking at them. Now, tell me the truth. Have you always have had to have faith? Do you always have faith? Now, let me ask you the other question. Have you ever had faith over something and you pray in faith and you believe in faith and you stand in faith, yet it did not happen? Why didn't it happen? Because faith fail not. Hello? So, what has happened that your own faith did not work? Because Hebrews still tells us, the last part of that Hebrews chapter 11, he said that even though they stood in faith, that they did not see their promises come to pass. That means that even faith in itself, sometimes God looks beyond what you could call, I am walking by faith, and needs you to come to another dimension of the supernatural. Can I help you to understand the next level of the supernatural? After faith, you have come by faith. Man of God, lay hands. They lay hands, they lay back. They prophesy, they prophesy. They throw you saliva, pour you water, use all the oil, and it is not working. Do you know another dimension that is available? It is called the dimension of anointing. Now, the anointing is the second dimension in the supernatural. What does the anointing do? Many times, the anointing does not need your faith. The anointing that is on the man of God can work signs and wonders even without their faith. Because himself has a covenant with God that what he says that God will honor it.
Are you understanding that? So he comes like that, Yoma. That Yoma said to you, whether you believe it or not, it will happen. Now that is a dimension known as the dimension of the anointing. So even if your faith does not carry you, tap into the anointing. That woman, faith in her heart. If I can only just touch the hem of his garment, what was she touching? The anointing that was in Jesus. She has spent all the money. Everything she had had failed her. So the only thing she can now do, faith is not working for her at that point. Because she has faith in the clinic, in the hospital, in everything. And in her money. So when Jesus was passing by, she now applied to the dimension of the anointing. She touched the hem of his garment. And what happened? Automatically, she was made whole. Tonight, if your faith has failed you, I have come with God's anointing. Your miracle will happen tonight. Today, 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 Jesus will answer you. Today, today. Today, oh, today, 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 Jesus will answer me, oh, today, today, amen. Somebody say amen. Now, how many of you know, now let me sit down again and ask you that. When I sit down, Lord, I'm going to be very, very serious. Tell me the truth. Don't lie. How many of you have been to or have seen people like Benny Hinn, Kenneth Hagin, or Kenneth Copeland, or these are our people that have kept from years ago? When I bunker, and you have seen that that man of God, everywhere he goes, power will move, healing will take place. People will come by faith and will come to believe God by the anointing he carried. Yet many people left without being healed. Faith and the anointing is lost. Yet people did not get healed. Has it happened before? Oh, tell me the truth now. Okay. So it means that faith and the anointing sometimes are inadequate. So what must we do? We now leave and go back home? No. The third dimension that will now bring you into the supernatural, whether you believe it or not, whether there's a man of God or no man of God, whether there is faith in you or no faith in you, is called the glory dimension. Now, the glory dimension supersedes faith, which is dependent on you, supersedes anointing, which is dependent on the man of God. It is now the supremacy of the sovereignty, where God himself will say, I am. He that has never lied. And I swore by myself, because when I looked for any other thing I could not find, then I had to swear by myself. Abraham, that land that I told you, I will give it to your children. So it has gone off from the hands of individuals, from the hands of the minister or the pastor, is now in God's own class. Aren't you happy that God can never lie to you? That is the dimension you are in now. It is the dimension of the glory. I say it's the dimension of the glory. When the glory of God descends, miracles happen with that prayer. While we are still singing, people throw away their wheelchairs and start walking out. Things happen without anybody praying for anybody. Why? Because that is the glory dimension. Tonight and throughout this year, for every one of you in this assembly, hear me and hear me well. You have come into the dimension of the glory of God. This is where God himself will walk, all by himself. This is when you are coming to this church, nobody is here. You come to this altar and you are answered, your prayers are answered. This is a dimension where prayer and fasting is not limiting the thing that God will do for you. Therefore, tonight, lift up your hands everywhere in this house. What did you ask the Lord for this year? Your faith may not carry you. Your pastor may not be there. But God. But God. Say to the Lord, I have exhausted all that I know. I live the battle with you now. My father's house battle. The battle in the office. The battle on campus. The battle in my business place. The battle in the church. Now it is your dimension, oh Lord. Your father's dimension. This is the dimension of the glory. Lift up your hands. Open your mouth. Begin to say to the Lord, my faith might fail me. I may not have the anointing, and the man of God may not be there. But I appeal to you, Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit of God, let your glory envelop me. Let your glory touch my life. Let your glory take me from here. Let your glory defend me. Let your glory help me out. Open your mouth, lift up your hands. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Jesus. Something to the Lord. He has never failed. He will never fail you. Come on, come on, church. Your mountain. Let the glory of God rest upon you. Let your situation be gone today. I see your testimonies delivered into your hands. The God of heaven is speaking over you now. The Lord shall bless you. The Lord shall increase you. The Lord shall favor you. The Lord shall cause his light to shine upon you. The Lord shall increase his word in your life. In the name of Jesus. Lift up your hand. Your right hand. Lift up your right hand. Your right hand is a hand of power. It's a hand of authority. The glory of the Lord is here. The glory of the Lord is here. Father, tonight, Let their glory envelop your children. Let their faith work for them. If that faith has failed them, let the anointing work for them. If the anointing has not reached them, let your glory work for them. In the name of Jesus, I command the door open for you now. I command the atmosphere charged for you now. I command the Holy Ghost rest upon you now. Receive in the name of Jesus. Now, open your eyes. Look at me. Everybody, look at me. Peter said to that beggar, look on us. Look with an expectation. Because I say to you tonight, that glory of God has appeared to you today. Everything I say now, just shout amen. If the anointing has not reached them, let your glory work for them. In the name of Jesus, your light has come upon you. Your victory has been released. Where you struggled before, now victory is yours. The God of heaven has gone ahead of you. Every crooked path in 2017 has been made straight. I see the Lord carrying you on his wings. Every weapon formed against you this year shall not prosper. I release you this year. Receive your victory. I said receive your victory. In the name of Jesus. Clap those hands, give him praise. Now, I command the door open for you now. I command the atmosphere charged for you now. I say to that beggar, look on us. Look with an expectation. Because
they were not told to do that. When the glory comes, what you do is not by manipulation. The glory of God will make you to begin to give willingly. I believe that in this season, there are people that God is going to raise in this church that will sponsor church programs. Why? Because out of the abundance that God has given to you, you will now sponsor the work of God. Whether it is flight ticket, hotel bills, whatever, you tell the pastor, don't worry, I will take care of this part of it. If you are among such people,
I say to you tonight, that glory of God has appeared to you today. Everything I say now, just shout amen. If the anointing has not reached them, let your glory work for them.
It will happen because somebody like you will sponsor the gospel. Are you among those people? Are you people like too many? Put down your hands. Don't say everybody. Even in the old, even in the Bible, not everybody knew the book. But there are too many. I only mean those who are serious. Father, in this year of your glory, I have made up my mind. Because your glory is bringing me into wealth, into prosperity. I will be one of the sponsors. Now lift up your right hand. I will be one of the sponsors. Every one of you, do you know what it will cost you? It's your commitment, isn't it? Please lift it up again. Wave it before the Lord. Are you ready? Okay. If you are going to be a true sponsor of this gospel, and you mean it from your heart, on Sunday, come with 10,000 naira. Put down your hands. Put down your hands now. Put down your hands. This is a sign. Someday, I will bring 10,000 naira to this house as a seed towards my wealth and my sponsorship, as touching the kingdom of God. Lift up your hand again. You see? That's what I'm trying to talk about. Lift up your hand. All of you. 10,000 naira by Sunday. All of you. I will give. Come out here. I want to just pray for you.
My trust is in you. Patient of days. My trust is in you. Dependable God.
Please,
my
trust is
in you.
Come fast.
I put them all in you. My trust is in you. Lion of Judah. My trust is in you. Ancient of days. My trust is in you.
Why are you people are not giving?
Dependable God. My trust is in you. I put them all in you. My trust is in you.
Please.
I put them all in you.
Come. Please. All of you. Between tomorrow, even this night, and Sunday. Did you hear what I said? Because heaven has taken pictures of all of you. This year is the beginning of greater years ahead of you. Please hear me. It's the beginning of greater years ahead of you. What you do in 2017 will determine what will happen to you in 2019. God spoke to me since last year. That's what I've been announcing. You want to join politics? What do you do this year? You want something? What do you do this year? All of you, shake my hand. God bless you. Please pass. Go back. I don't take your name. Heaven has taken your name. How many are there? Let me know your number. God bless you. Tomorrow till Sunday, bring your 10,000.
My trust is in you. Ancient of days. My trust is in you. Dependable God. My trust is in you. I put them all in you. My trust is in you.
Come on, wave your hands. Now, calm down. You know, some people, because they said my faith is not taking me, if it is less than that, I can do it. 5,000, come out now. All of you that will be sponsors of the gospel from 2017 is your year. Come out here. Come out. Please don't wait. When you hear this, don't wait. Just rush down.